We talk a lot about quantum computing, but the reality hasn't yet arrived. But Apple wants to front run that.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. That's right. Quantum computing, some estimates indicate that these types of computers, which are super duper computers, not just supercomputers, so to speak, won't arrive until the tail end of the decade or deep into the 2030s. But Apple's starting to prepare for that with iMessage. Let me tell you why. There's something called harvest now, decrypt later attacks, right? What that means is someone could steal some data now, even though it's unbreakable now, quantum computers in the future may be able to break it open, right? So Apple wants to stop that from happening. They don't want someone to collect or steal someone's iMessage data in the year 2025 and then crack it open in 2032. And so that's what this new iMessage PQ3 technology is going to do. It's much improved encryption for the platform. It's rolling out next month when Apple releases its next software updates, iOS 17.4 being the big one. And then it's going to become the default for all iMessage conversations by the end of this year.
And saying it's more efficient or effective, at least, than Signal, of course, than other competitors out there, WhatsApp and the like. Mark, I'm interested in also your reporting that you've done overnight on really some executive changes going on at Apple. This seems to be a never-ending story.
Yeah, it's interesting. More executive changes at Apple. This one in its audio division. Gary Jeeves, who's their vice president of acoustics, one of their top executives related to audio, really has been the leader and at the forefront of the development of AirPods over the last decade or so, which obviously now is a $15 to $20 billion a year business for Apple. He has stepped down as of this week from his role. He's given that role to his top deputy. He's going to remain for the next several months at Apple as an advisor, right? So no longer running the team, but an advisor to Apple's executive in charge of Beats, AirPods now, the HomePod, and other audio products. So more executive changes. This comes after DJ Novotny, who was a key vice president of hardware engineering there, left to be a senior vice president of program management at Rivian earlier this year. Tang Tan, the vice president of design for the iPhone, the Apple Watch, and AirPods, he's going to join former Apple design chief Johnny Ive at his company, Love From, working on new AI products with Sam Altman. And you've seen a large chunk of Apple's industrial design team leave as well. So this is not a departure yet, but key executives stepping down from their role.